Okay, let's look at the RAM here. We're going to use CPUs, the software, go to memory here. And you can see in this system, there's DDR3 and 8 gigabytes. Now, this is a single RAM card that we have in here. We go check SPD, that it says slot one. Yeah, slot one has one stick. A PC3 12800 megahertz. G-Skill DDR3. Okay, and you see the others don't currently have a RAM card. And we're going to install four new ones here. And for a total of 32 gigabytes, they're 8 gigabytes each. Gigastone. Okay. Okay, we're going to put some new RAM in here. Gigastone RAM, 4 8 gigabyte cards. Now, I guess first things first, I can put that right there. Let's take this one out, the old one, this old G-Skill. There's only one there. There we go. Goes in that way. All right, good enough. Let's get these fellows out. Toss that right on the floor. Here we go. Okay. Okay. Let's get this one out if I can. Don't want to break them. All right. We got this one. Slide it down through here. Okay, I was being a little bit too shy with that. It's in there. Now, the second one. They're fairly well packaged here. Okay, now let's take out the other Gigastone here. My goodness, okay. Okay, now. Let's open this one up, move over the tab here, make sure it slid right down there.
Okay. This is DDR3 RAM?
DDR3. Here we go, gotcha. That one was a little easier.
There's levers on each side of the carriage, yes?
Yes, there is. Now, two more. Need to take the scissors. There we go.
Yeah, you can lock the cards, the RAM cards, in with the levers on the sides, yes?
Yeah, they got these individually tightened up, so you can put them away if you don't want to use all of them. But we want to use all four of these.
So now we'll have 32 gigs of RAM in the system.
Guaranteed. Oh my.
So what's the motherboard here, do you know?
It's an ASRock. Oh, goodness, I've forgotten. We'll have to write that down in the description.
Okay.
Uh,
Oh my goodness. I don't know why that one was so tight.
It's finally
in there. That one was a lot tighter than I would have liked. But it should be fine. It will be fine. Really tight. Okay. We're going to get some more information on this computer after we run CPUs on it again. There, that one went in a lot easier. Okay, they're in, and they should be easily ready to go. That one there was a little bit more, had to kind of jiggle it a little bit, but 4 8-gigabyte sticks of RAM from Gigastone, and they fit in fine. Okay, let's get this back on there. You don't need to just hand tighten it. You don't want to break anything, because you can over tighten something like this. Good to go.
Okay.
We just replaced the RAM with, let's go to memory here on CPUs. DDR3, 32 gigabytes. That's what's in here now. It's saying dual channel, but there's 4 cards in here. Let's go through slot 1 here. You can see is DDR3, PC3, 12, 800 megahertz is what it's showing here. That probably could be set in BIOS, because I believe there's 1600, pardon me. But we're going to leave this for, like this for now. Showing up as Samsung rather than Gigastone. I guess they're using Samsung chips. No matter, there's one in the first slot, one in the second slot, one in the third slot, and one in the fourth. So you can see there's a card in each slot now. We're going to go back to CPU. Here is AMD FX6300, codename Vishera. Core voltage 1.3, 1.2, that's counting up and down, it's keeping track of it here. Let's go to the main board, an ASRock board, ASRock model number 970M Pro 3, PCI Express 2.0. Now again, these are Gigastone cards, memory cards, showing up as Samsung. There you go. Graphics here is NVIDIA GeForce GT710 for now. That will probably be changed in the near future. Looks good. All that went in fine. No problem whatsoever. I was kind of concerned about the third one, but it went in after, and you can see through SPD, the third, all slots are occupied with an 8-gigabyte card. We're good. 32 gigabytes of RAM in this computer now. A lot better for video editing. Excellent.